The best way to describe stigma is to think about a feeling that somebody might have towards something that they don't approve of. The person that is being disapproved of will feel some sort of negative judgment. They might feel that that person is displaying bias or that they don't agree with the choices or actions that they're making. The negative perception of that behaviour and the result that that has is stigma. We see a lot of stigma towards alcohol and other drug use, that it can prevent people from reaching out for help or support where it's needed because they may feel that they'll be negatively judged for their actions. Just because they're using a substance, it doesn't mean that they have an issue with their substance use. Judging them or making an assumption about their substance use without having a conversation is stigmatizing to that person. There are a lot of ways that we can help to fight stigma in our society. One of the most prominent ways that we can help is by choosing the language that we use carefully, using language that is stigmatizing, so calling somebody a junkie or saying that they are addicted to a substance, as opposed to talking about their substance use in a helpful way. It is not going to allow the conversation to progress in a way that's helpful for either person participating. Lots of different people use alcohol and other drugs for lots of different reasons. They may be using medications to help manage a health problem. They may be using alcohol to decompress, to celebrate, to commiserate. They may just be choosing to use substances on one-off occasions when they're out with friends socialising. Judgments towards these behaviours don't necessarily stop them from happening. So where people feel discrimination or stigma about their alcohol or other drug use, they are less likely to be open about it, to discuss it, to seek help, as opposed to if we are open, if we are accepting, if we provide information and engage in conversation, then people can learn about the circumstances around their alcohol and other drug use and where they may require additional assistance or support. So we should be conscious of stigma because it can be really unhelpful. While it can act to discourage behaviours or actions that society doesn't want to see, it can be really damaging to the individual who's receiving the stigma or judgment. It's something that we need to be conscious of if we want to be supportive and if we want to actually allow people to make informed or healthy decisions. So where people experience stigma for their alcohol or other drug use, they are potentially more likely to stop being public about that use. That means that they are less likely to share that use with other people or to talk about it and to keep it hidden. So when it's hidden, it's less likely that there are going to be open conversations about the ramifications of that use. Avoiding stigma as an individual who is perceiving somebody else's substance use can be as easy as reflecting on that substance use before speaking with the individual. It can be challenging your own held beliefs about substance use and how you feel about something. Something that might not feel right for you might be okay for another person. It's being open to that and making sure that we're being supportive and inclusive. Regardless of whether they are or are not using substances, they're still people. Everybody uses different substances for different reasons, and that shouldn't affect the way that you treat them as a person. If you're looking for more information about how to reduce stigma, there's a couple of places that you can go. You can have a look at our CODE website, which is full of resources that cover things like stigma and discrimination and how to think about your role in that. We have a great suite of training offerings, including general alcohol and other drug workshops, which cover topics like stigma and discrimination, why people might use substances, and the effect that substance use can have on their life. We just want to support people who are using substances to do so in an informed way so that they're aware of the risks and they're aware of support available to them if that's something that they feel that they need.